Hey everyone, my name is Shagun and today we're gonna be learning how can you create this beautiful moon in hand edit using Adobe Photoshop. Before we go and someone ask about these stocks, I just want to say that you can download them from free. You can get the northern sky and the moon from the link in the description. I cannot give you the models link because I do not have permissions to do it. You can capture on your own. Just hold a light source in your hand and point the light source towards your face or the part which you want to make glow with respect to the moon. However, you can do it manually in Adobe Photoshop, but if you can do it in real life, why not do it? Anyways, considering that you have photos, let's learn how to do it. So the first step here I'm doing is selecting everything except the sky. Fairly easy to do because we are going to add northern lights for the sky. I'm using quick selection tool for selecting here. You can use any tool which you like, or the funny thing, this might not even be required for your photo. However, after making selection, do not forget to add a layer mask over your layer so that we can get more hand over the selection. That's all for this phase. Let's move to another one for adding the northern lights. Okay, the next step. That is the placement of northern lights which we downloaded. Once you import them in Photoshop, add it under your background or the source photo. After that, I spent a little time to see position of the northern lights which suits this composition. Once I found it, I click on that check mark. That's it. Once I place the northern lights, I noticed that there are some white fringes over the selection which we made earlier. Since it was not so much, I decided to erase them manually rather than contracting the selection, right? That's why we need to have a layer mask. Because now I can erase my unwanted stuff easily, and if I erase something by mistake, I could get it back. Again, that's an easy stuff, nothing much. So yeah, let's go. Okay, the next step, simply adding the moon PNG to your photo. Again, using the transformation tool, we decide to place it over the hand. You may be placing the moon on something surface or some other part rather than hand. Well, if you go for it, then there are chances that you'll need a shadow of the moon or maybe a glow below it. If you're like me holding in hand, make sure you get the fingers out of the moon. I mean, make sure that you do not hide your fingers with your moon. Otherwise, it would just look fake, right? Yes. So again, find the perfect spot and then click the check icon when you're done with transformation tool. Now, only two steps are left to finish this beautiful composite. Let's go. Okay, the next step is going to be, we are going to duplicate the layer and then convert it to smart object, and then we are going to make a quick rough selection of the person so that we have a separate layer for the person, because now we are going to make adjustments on the person and we want the adjustments to only affect the person. So that's why we are making a quick rough selection. After selection, we are going to drag the layer which we made just now to the top of this composition. Once you do it, you may see some unwanted stuff of your selection which is above the moon. Well, simply erase it by using our favorite layer mask. Now, after that, I added a hue and saturation layer and then I clip mask it by hitting that small button. I added a bit of positive side hue and some negative side lightness. However, I could add a little bit of saturation, but I didn't. The next thing that I did was to add the green color to the mountains as the environment is a bit green. So I color sampled that northern lights and then I painted brush over the mountains. And then I changed the blend mode to the soft light of that layer. I did the same for water side as well. I just reduced a little bit of opacity of that layer. After that, I saw some unwanted greens, so I removed greens from the parts which I did not want it, such as hairs of the body and hand of the body. That's all, and now we are moving to add the glow to the moon. So yeah, let's go. So for the final moon glow, I created a new layer and then I sampled the bright yellow color from the moon's layer. Then I selected the new layer and then I created a ball or just a brush stroke over the moon. After that, I changed the blend mode of that layer to screen to get a visible detail in the moon. And then I reduced a little bit of opacity from the layer so that we have again more visibility and less glow. Now the final adjustment layer, the curves one, where I made a small S curve to get the final things done. So we are finally done with our photo. Congratulations, you're holding a moon in your hand. Now final talk to you guys. So I hope you have enjoyed the video and I hope that you finally learned how to add a moon in your hand. Although this wasn't much hard, but yet a lot of people asked for the tutorial of this photo. I know that there might be some steps different for your own photo, so if you need some other extra help, you can comment or ask me in the Instagram DMs or emails. I might be there to reply you and help you. The basic idea of this video was not to make you copy exactly, but just to give you an idea that how I created that so that you may get an inspiration or motivation or reference to create one for yourself. I will be glad if you will share this video with your friends and hit that like, subscribe, follow, comment and whatever the business is. And I would love to know your suggestions about this video. I know that there were some things off with this video as well, but again, I do not edit much videos, so I don't have much experience. With the time, there will be a lot of improvements in my videos. Anyway, so I hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure you share and whatever. So yeah, thanks for watching.